Hi everyone, welcome, welcome. I'm glad you're here. This is Sunday sketch session, starting a little late today. The morning got busy and things got away from me, so it is 1:30 in the afternoon. I am on my last cup of coffee for the day. I have out all of my colored pencils. Yes? Yes, all of my Castle Art colored pencils. I do have other colored pencils. I just don't have them back here. These are all my color. These are metallics, the tints, and the 72 set of colored pencils, and then this is the 120 set of watercolor pencils, these cups over here. The basket's a temporary situation. I have other more pretty stuff on the way, but for now, this is how things are arranged. I got these cool, cute cups, and they're all multicolored. I guess I could tip this a bit like this. Yeah, they're all multicolored so that I can, everything's color coded for me because I like color coding, so that I know what's where. And I put them all in this basket for now, and they're on the table. I'm gonna scooch them off to the side so we can grab from the bucket. And today we're gonna do some, we're gonna just do some gnarly practice drawing gnarly trees. I'm gonna open up the book. Find us our gnarly tree page. I chose this last night for a subject matter because I've been really working in my animal sketchbook all week last week, and I need to break away from that a little bit, so I thought we would get in here and just play with color and draw some weirdly colored trees. Why not, right? So I'm just gonna jump right in. I'm gonna zoom in a bit so you can really see the sketch page a lot. Let's switch these guys over more. There we go. And then I need to put something on the page for my camera to focus on because it's just that way. yeah, we're gonna go ahead and just jump right in. Yeah, I'm just gonna do a little practice of trees on the spread. We have an hour before I need to start doing other things because I time block my stuff. In order to keep on schedule and doing all the things that I want to do for you guys, between YouTube and Patreon and the shop and the day job and, you know, being able to still have a life and get out and do things without feeling overwhelmed, I do time blocks. I block out my time so that I know roughly what my day looks like and where I need to tweak and bend and keep things flexible throughout the day. I don't block out every minute of the day. I just block out set times to do certain things, and I leave windows of open time for downtime, to rest my eyes, to keep myself sane, to not overwhelm myself and be doing too much. So I block out usually an hour for sketching a day, no matter what time of day it is. Purposeful sketching, like I'm purposely going to do sketching for an hour in the sketchbooks. And whether that's, you know, break away from TV, and life for a little while and come back here and sit and just scribble on the page. That usually puts me in a flow state and I want to create more. I want to do more. I want to get in here and stay in here in the art room. When I say in here, I mean in the craft room, art room. It's not really a craft room. I don't really craft anymore. I used to. But I found that blocking out my time really helps me stay focused and on task with all the things. And it gives me time to also enjoy life. Not get too wrapped up in being in the art room and constantly creating, because you don't want to burn yourself out. But feeling satisfied with all the things on all the different levels. I hope that makes sense. But yeah, so I blocked out an hour of time today. I have My personal project that I'm working on, which I need to film for Patreon later this afternoon. After this session, I'm going to work on that after I eat. I'm actually really hungry right now. I haven't had lunch yet. I got lost down the rabbit hole of looking at reference photos and planning, and that's another thing. You get lost down rabbit holes, right? The YouTube. I got lost down the cute babies rabbit hole yesterday and a little bit today. And then my boyfriend and I got lost down the I'm following Victorian houses on Instagram. And we sat on the couch for literally an hour and a half this morning just looking at Victorian houses on Instagram and going, ooh, oh, I don't like that. And wow, that's awesome. It's just so silly. And finally he stood up. He's like, all right, I gotta go. You get to your things. And yeah, we gotta stop because we're gonna be here all afternoon and pretty soon you're going to be upset because you didn't do your art and I didn't do my things and it'll be 4 o'clock in the afternoon. And he's completely right. Get lost in Instagram feed, the Reels feed. The babies get me. Dogs. There was a dog one this morning of this poor dog, this giant, giant dog getting a bath. Just howling his little heart out. He was not happy. It was funny. Poor thing. Yeah, watched that one twice just because it was so funny. I went back to it twice. Yeah, so, you know, you guys know the phone, the feed can become all consuming and pull you away from things. I've discovered for me especially that it pulls me away from my art and what I want to do in my day artistically, creatively. And then, you know, pretty soon I'm dissatisfied with life and things are chaos and yeah, everything gets dramatic. I didn't do what I wanted to do. The world is acting. And I'm grumpy for no reason. I can't figure out why I'm upset. And what it comes down to is I didn't create today. I didn't draw anything. I didn't paint. I didn't do anything today. And I found that for my emotional well-being, I need to draw or paint something, at least for a little bit of the day, every day. Every day. If I don't, I don't feel like my day is right. And I know not everybody's that way. I mean, creating every day is a lot. But I do all this stuff for Patreon and YouTube, and I also create for myself. Things I want to do, passion projects. I have several on the board, lined up and ready to rock and roll. And I'm excited about them. I'm excited about this whole year right now and how things are going and where things are heading. And I want to stay in that zone, you know? And I found that time blocking really helps me with that. It helps me in my day job, which is why I do it in this, in my art job. As it were, which I would love for this to be my day job. I'd love to just create all day, every day. I'm most happy when I'm in my art room, creating. Well, I'm, yeah, most happy, most content. Not to say that other things don't bring me joy, because they do, the kids, the grandkids, but for me personally, my personal well-being, my mental state of being, and my personal wellness, because, I mean, if you're not well yourself, right, you can't give to others as much as you would like to, in the most positive of ways. I've found, for me, that is my reality. And it is for most people, I would imagine. If you're not caring for yourself, and you're not at your best, how are you giving your best to others? And I'm a giver and a pleaser, and I like to do for, and I just like to. It makes me feel happy. And without any expectation of return investment or return reciprocation of any kind, I don't really think about it, the reciprocation part. It just doesn't occur to me, which has gotten me in trouble in the past because, you know, that if you're not careful, people take advantage and all that, but... yeah, I think I want to make foliage bigger on this, like, yeah, like that. More, like that. Do you guys agree? Yeah. Yep, doing it quickly. Maybe we sharpen the pencil. This, by the way, is a great sharpener. I got it in an art box. It's mapped. It came in my Palettefull Packs box this month. It's really... this month? Yes, I think this month or last month. And it's a really nice sharpener. Gives great point. It works every time. It does jam up a little bit here and there, but not enough to make me not want to use it. Which is, you know, kind of key. Whoops, tip broke off. Get in here. I'm trying to remember that I'm sketching. I don't need to be super exact. And my light is leaning on my table, so sorry if you guys heard that. Put in some more branches, kind of willy-nilly. They don't have to be exact because, I mean, nobody knows but me, right? You don't know what my tree looks like, man. Don't judge. Alright, where's that tree? Looking pretty good. Maybe this is another... like it goes off like that. There we go. How do we like that one? It's neat, huh? Let's throw another color on there. So we're gonna get wild with colors and I don't do it. Purple and... ooh, let's use a watercolor with this intense... Bangle Rose. Let's throw that in here. Ooh. Crazy. Overlap some areas. I'll give it some interest. Oh yeah, I'm digging that. That looks neat. Rose there. And then maybe put some touches of it down here. Like that. And then go in with maybe... ooh. This blue in the watercolor. Sky blue. Getting crazy. Over that purple here and there a little bit, like that. Oh, yeah, I dig it. And come in here and do a light dusting across the entire trunk of the tree, like that. My world, I can make my trees look however I want. What do you guys think? Digging it? Like that. Oh yeah. Alright. I dig that. Where's my water? Oh, it's back behind here. I'm gonna grab water and any old paintbrush. This one looks kind of stiff. I didn't clean that one very well. Let's put that down. Grab this one. This is a Robert Simmons S85 Sapphire round number 6. And I have a bunch of Robert Simmons Sapphire brushes and in the different ranges. And I have a lot of Princeton Neptune brushes in the different ranges. Now this isn't going to smudge out the colored pencil that I used, but it is going to smudge out the watercolor pencil that I used on top of the colored pencil. So I thought we'd just play with it. What do you guys think? We have room for tons more trees, so I need to pick up my pace. Went to Barnes & Noble yesterday, picked up another... ooh, I can show you guys that. Picked up a couple new books. So exciting. Hold on, I'll show you in a minute. Ooh, sucker. Ah, that fell down pretty hard. All right, hold on, I gotta fix this. Okay, I'm back. My screen fell. I had it propped on this little pop out tray that I bought on Amazon that I use for my Kindle and my phone. Thought it could hold that heavier screen. It cannot. Lesson learned. Let's come in and move around some of that blue and pink softly. I don't want to. The paper's pretty smooth. It doesn't have a lot of tooth. So it's gonna allow me to really push this color around if I push too hard on the paper. Get a little glow right there. Maybe it's a magical tree. Who knows? Who knows? Yeah, I take it. Alright, that's tree one. Oh, I was going to show you guys the two new books that I got at Barnes and Noble. That's wet. Sorry, it'll be fine. I got the new, well, a new. I don't know when this comes out. I gotta figure out when this actually releases. This magazine is amazing. It's Imagine FX Presents Sketchbooks. This is their sketchbooks series. And they showcase different artists in the magazine, their sketchbooks and whatnot. And I mean, just so everybody knows, there's a lot of stuff in here that is outside your comfort zone from my normal. But what I want to get practice a lot is creature design, world building. This year I want to widen my scope and my range, but this book is full of artwork from, I mean, it's literally 164 pages of work, of artwork. Individual people, each drawing has a blurb about what is going on in the piece, and you know, a little explanation, which is so great. And I love these magazines. I'm addicted. I'm hooked. I can't get enough. It's awesome. And yeah, thought I would share that. I'm going to be doing sketches from this in my sketchbooks for practice. That's one of the reasons I got these. I was like, this would be amazing practice. Like, I could get in here and I could practice doing this page and just flip to another page and, ooh, look at that. That's cool. I could try to do that and this, and just study from other artists, their styles. And that will give me a different feel and a different range within my own work is what my thoughts are. And different, because I don't usually draw simplistic like this. And I'd like to be able to go from this to this at my leisure. So yeah, I love this book. I got it at Barnes & Noble. It is a $30 magazine, but to my mind, it is well worth the content that's in it. So amazing. And it is in addition to, and if you haven't seen my previous videos, I got these three a week ago, 2 weeks ago. The Volume 1 Sketchbooks, Art School, and their annual magazine as well. So I'm kind of not. There we go. And then this is like an addition to that series. I saw this is the only one they had at the bookstore too, and I scooped it up. Could not do it. They're amazing. Amazing. So happy. And then my boyfriend dragged me over to the discount area where all the books are like half off. Like, they're severely marked down. And I found this dragon art book. And I've been looking for a decent dragon art book for ages. and ages. And we ended up sitting, I sat on the floor for a good half hour, just leafing through all the different kinds of art books. Monet, there was a Japanese artist, a big book like this of all of his works, several other artists, their names are not going to come to me because I'm so excited about this, but this book is beautiful, and I would love to try to recreate some of the pieces in here. I mean, it's just dreamy. You can't see the whole book. I would have to zoom out. Zoom, zoom. There we go. Now you can see the book. I'm gonna knock over my coffee. I'm gonna spill my pencils. Too excited. We'll just leaf through this really quickly, like this. That's so cool. Just really quickly, because I could sit and go through this whole book page by page and talk about what I like in each page. Like, the backgrounds are intense. Never mind the dragon. Check out that background detail. That the atmosphere the dragon is in is so realistic. Dig it so much. There's some darker works in here. Every page is just something new and beautiful. Look at that. The lines of the dragon. These dragons have feathers and like bat part of their wing is bat-like. This one's got feathers. I love it when creators do that. They don't go traditional, what I view as more traditional dragon art like this. This one was one of my boyfriend's favorites, but I like that it shows the different inspiration for creating this piece. Yeah, dig it. Dig it, dig it. So great. But yeah, we could seriously sit and go through this whole book. Look at that. They gave this one human hands. Kind of creeps me out a little bit. Okay, I'm not gonna lie. Thought that was gorgeous. Look at this. Like the idea. And then, I love this kind of stuff. It is great to, now, copy from other people, but make it your own. Like, copy to learn, and then do your own. Take the elements that you like and make it your own. But I thought these were cool. This whole card concept, create a portrait of a dragon. That's so neat. Look at the little baby. Yeah. I'll show you one last one that was one of my favorites, but it's stuck in my head. Let's see if I can find it real quick. We can get back to sketching trees, because I know we weren't going to talk about dragons all day today, right? This is on a cover of a book that I own. This is the cover of Dragon Print series of books that I own that you can't get anymore. They're out of print, and I own all 6 books, and this is the cover on one of them. I thought that was cool. Let's see, where is it? Come on. I know it was one of the first pages. Hold on, we'll find it. And if this isn't your thing, you can fast forward through this part. I don't mind. It's not gonna hurt my feelings. Where is it? Nope. Oh, I liked his head. Just the different shape of his head and the feel of his wings. Thought he was cool. Let's see if I can find it real quick. I didn't think it was this far back. Apparently it was. My basket's in the way. Oh, there it is. This one. Just the line of this dragon and the sweep of the wings and the color palette. All these, what could be castles or houses or just weirdly shaped rocks. And then the kids. This looks like kids. He's got the, that's just, that whole concept is crazy to me. I'm gonna zoom in. Zoom. Isn't that gorgeous? And the water's beautiful and the markings. I love this one. I mean, don't get me wrong, I love a bunch of the other ones as well, but this one stuck in my head from all night last night. But yeah. So I got a new dragon book, you guys. And never mind the dust cover, right? Flip, and the actual cover is so much more vibrant and beautiful. Love it. Love it. Yeah. Dig it. Here's the back. Oops-a-daisy. I just threw something away. The back of the book. It's a gorgeous book. For $15? $15? This is amazing. Love it. All right. So that's what I got at the bookstore. Oh, I threw away my little... I need this. Can't I throw that away? All right, so that's my little share. If you're interested in seeing dragon art or practicing dragon art with me, let me know in the comments below. I'd love to do some dragon art with you guys. It'd be super fun. All right, let's draw some more trees. Let's draw some trees. Oh, I can't use that one with my finger. It doesn't work that way. Let's go back and pick a different cool tree. Let's see. Ooh, this guy is neat. We'll do him. Okay. I need a color. Well, a color would be good. Ooh, this berry color. It's cherry. I'm going to move over here. Is that all right? Is it focused? Okay. Move over here. Kind of get in our ground. And we're going to... This is my favorite kind of tree to draw. The gnarled, gnarly, root-bound, kind of crazy-looking, old, old tree. Like that. Yeah, we went to Barnes & Noble. We ended up wandering around. We actually went to the comic store, too. Oh, I could have showed you my comic. It's out in the living room. Next video. Next Sunday's video, I'll show you guys the newest comics that I have. There's a series called Saga that I just got. I don't have the first book yet. It's like this thick. And it's all of the series up to the book that I bought yesterday, which is the rest of the series minus one comic that just came out, which my boyfriend is going to look for me when he goes to the comic book store on the weekend, because he has a membership, because he orders all regularly, and he gets a free comic a week out of the bins, out of the big bins. Yeah. You know, an old issue, not a new issue. Usually he finds me my comics, because I want some of the older stuff in the bins of older stuff. So he's going to look for the Saga issues that I don't have. Because it came out a while ago. And I just found the story at Barnes & Noble last time we went to Barnes & Noble. And hemmed and hawed and Pshawed, and then I went to Barnes & Noble by myself and looked at the book again. I sat on the floor and looked at it again. And yeah, it stuck in my head, so I'm like, alright, I'll break down and get myself a new series, plus there's some really cool covers to do, you know, to recreate in my own way. Do a little bit of fan art, I guess. And yeah. Totally, totally can't wait to read the story. Can't wait to show you guys all the art. And that, for me, a lot of the reason why I got interested in comic books is the art. Some of the work that goes into the covers and the interior art of these books is, it's just crazy astounding how much time and energy is put into the creation of something that essentially used to be for children. Nowadays, it's its whole thing, right? We adults love our comics too, dang it. And some comics are not for kids at all. No. They're adult stories. But yeah, the Saga one I'm really excited to read. I found a couple other ones that I'm interested to get. Maybe throughout the year this year I'll pick them up, you know, as I get done reading the ones that I have. Because my last Berserker magazine should be coming soon. And then I can read that series. I need to sit down and read through my Alien series. Yeah, super excited. Super excited. I love my comics. If you're not into comics, you know, sorry. Sorry, not sorry. It's a passion of mine that my boyfriend feeds, because he's been into comics since he's been collecting, like avidly collecting for years, for his whole life. It's his one of his passions. Not the only one, just, you know. We all have our things, right? Mine is art supplies. I'm gonna do my own thing a little bit on this tree and make things make sense to me. And this is one of the watercolor pencils. Oh no, it's not. It's a regular color pencil. So yeah. Had a nice time at Barnes & Noble, had a great time at the comic shop. Oh, and I found on the wall, I'll put it up right here, on the wall in the comic shop was three really cool paintings of, I think it was Harley, I'm pretty sure it was Harley, Batman and Joker. Three individual pieces, very simple but so cool. I took a little picture and a video clip of them. They're pretty high up on the wall, so the perspective is probably a little off, but they're really cool. I dig them. The style, really neat. You guys can let me know what you think in the comments below, if you think they're neat or just weird or whatever. You know, every opinion is valid. Art makes you feel how it makes you feel, man. Yeah. Digging this tree. All right, let's get in. I'm getting lost in the details up top and not putting in, like, the body of the tree. And you don't need to be, you just need to get all the lines going in an appropriate direction for growth. Like, yeah. Or you can make it as fantastical as you want. I've made some trees pretty crazy looking. Do a little dark spot there, like that. How are they looking? Pretty cool. So yeah, I had a good time yesterday. We got back. I came back here and did a couple art things. He caught up on some TV that he wanted to watch. He's watching several different shows. Ones that I'm not interested in watching, like Teen Titans, there's too much to get into right now. Eventually I'll watch it, just not right now. And I came back here yesterday and did yesterday's sketch video for Patreon, and was it yesterday's sketch? Yeah. And edited a video, put that up. I was back here for quite a while. Working on some art things yesterday. Then we ate food. We had leftover, what did we eat yesterday? Leftover meatloaf and mashed potatoes. So delicious. So good. I love mashed potatoes. It's a situation. And then we watched a couple of episodes of Ghosts on Paramount? Yeah, Paramount. I get Paramount through Amazon. It's like $9 a month. I get it. I watch the stuff that we want to watch, and then I cancel it so that I'm not paying for it when I'm not using it, which I love about the Amazon channels. You can cancel them when you're not using them, when you're not watching anything on them, which is awesome. That. Get some gnarly things going on up here. We're coming down this way and up this way. So we watched 3 episodes of season 2 of Ghost. It's so funny, you guys. It is so funny. And it's a recommended show if you want to watch something clean and funny, a little silly. Yeah, it's really good. I think it's the American version of a BBC show. We both tried to watch the BBC show, and it wasn't quite what we were expecting. Didn't quite work out. But this version is super funny. I'm digging it a lot. And yeah, so we watched a couple episodes of that, and then I came back here and did some more art things, and I sketched in my sketchbook, and then we went to bed. And he had things to do with his mom and his dad, and then he's going home. So he took off at around 10 this morning. And then I got lost down that rabbit hole of dogs and babies and sat on the couch for a little while. Then I came back here and got things set up to do this video and work on my stuff for the rest of the afternoon. It's fun to just do, I do gnarly trees out of my head all the time. I just make them up. Rule of thumb for trees and doing any kind of tree thing is the trunk needs to be, it goes consecutively smaller as it goes up. Trunks are bigger than branches, branches are bigger than twig limbs, and limbs are smaller than the twiggy parts, and so on and so forth. So you can pretty much make a tree look however you want. If you've looked up trees, they come in every imaginable shape and size and configuration. It's crazy what nature does sometimes. Let's get in some shading, and we're gonna have a little purple tree over here. A little purple tree trunk. Should we put in other colors, or should we just leave it purple? I don't know. Kind of like a purple. You know what we could do? We could put in some shrubbery. What's this color? Delph blue. Ooh, interesting. I'll come in and put in some blue shrubbery around our purple tree. How about that? Like that. Coming down. Like that. And then don't be afraid to draw over certain elements of your design to make it look like it's within instead of, you know, stuck on. Because that makes things interesting. Gives it visual appeal, and it looks a touch more realistic if that's what you're going for. Ta-da! Okay, we're done with that tree. Let's do a different one. Let's see. Oh, I can't scroll with my finger on that. I usually have my Kindle up here, but it's charging. It died on me. Oh, this is kind of fantastical looking. Let's do this one. This might not be a real tree, but we're gonna plan to do it anyways. We're doing it. All right. Let's see. Well, let's use some of our pastel colors. All right, so you guys can see where I'm picking from. These are the tints in the Castle Arts tint collection. They're very beautiful, very pastel-y. And we're gonna go with this crazy one. I feel like we're doing pinks and blues. Let's grab some green Ooh, and a gold. Green and gold? Why not? And maybe this bluish green? What do we think? Oh, I need kind of I don't want to do pink, so we'll do orange for the, it's either fruits or flowers. It's going to be abstract enough that it won't matter. We'll start with our tree trunk. We'll put it right down here. It's going to be a little tree trunk right here. Coming up out of the forest floor. Like that. Am I out of frame? No, I'm not. I could use a heavier hand though, so you guys could see what I'm doing. These are very kind of muted colors, and I am using the tree as a guide and for my practice and branching off.
See what I did there?
Branching off when I feel the need and doing my own thing when I want to. There, and then she's gonna come up like this. One of those trees that has many branches coming out of it. Right? At all different angles. Like that. So much going on that you can't tell where the branches are and where the branches stop and start. Especially from a distance. Like that. Get this guy in, his basic shape. Goes up like that. I know it looks crazy right now, but give me a minute. And then we'll put in some foliage and it'll make more sense. That's the gist of the base of the tree shape. Like that, it's got this, like the branches start growing pretty short. And out like that. And it's got a sturdy base, like a sturdy stout base, like that. Yeah, dig it. All right, let's go ahead and tint it with the blue. Just lock it in real quick. Like so, so I don't forget where the branches are and how they go. Like that. Like that, and like that. Good. And then up here, we have all kinds of twigs coming from and two and four and what have you, like that. Give it some structural weight, like that. There, this one's back behind, so it'll be nice and dark. There's a lot of textures and lines and deep grooves in the tree. So just drag my pencil and kind of spin it as I work to give myself less control over what the line is going to do. It's a technique. You don't have to do it that way. If you want to be more exacting, you can totally go slower and, you know, work it out. Make it be your tree. The tree you want it to be. Alright, let's get a little heavy shadow in the bottom of that limb. There. That limb there. And then there's some deep grooves and shadows down here. The base of the tree kind of comes up like that. Neat, right? And don't think you need to be putting your marks in like a linear pattern. They can go all kinds of directions. It's a tree. If you look at the bark of the tree, it's terribly complex on some of them. You're never going to get it all. Okay, let's put the light blue down. Well, you roll over there then. Alright, I'm going to... I feel like I should do a... Let's do... Let's stick with this. I was going to go gold. Might have to sharpen this for the foliage. Completely different color palette than the actual reference photo. Because I can. Because I want this to be my practice. Doing what I want to do. Gold. And then some gold. Like bright gold there. And this is a full foliage tree. Like there's so much foliage happening, overlapping, in behind, going over the top, just scribbling it in, get that basic shape going, like this, got some floating out down here, little bits hanging down, little bits hanging down. That. I know it doesn't make sense yet, but it will. Have a little faith in me. Alright. That. My pencil. I'm gonna lose my flat edge. Alright, we'll go as far as we can until I get down to the wood part of the pencil. It's going out this way. This little bushy foliage top. There's all kinds of stuff happening with this tree. All kinds of crazy stuff. It's fantastic. We've got one more coming out this way. It's one of those trees reach bottom. You're looking at it like, how are you even standing? Oh, broke, booger. There we go, okay. That. Yeah, like that. Good. then over here, got this, this whole section down here. Cool looking tree, right? It's got all kinds of crazy stuff happening. Alright. That's the gold, and then for the shadowy areas, we're gonna come in with the purpley color. Come over the top. This. Get in some shape and interest and definition. Things happening. Like that. Yeah. And we can even use this on the tree trunk to kind of give it some more weight. Fun, fun, okay. That might have to come in with a darker, a non-pastel color in a minute here. My light is vibrating off the desk. Serious shadow stuff going on through there. We've got a little layering effect happening here. There's shadow here. Right? And there's some shadow down here. Like that. Yeah. It's interesting. It's interesting. Just noticed I'm kind of working in this direction and all my lines are going that way. Something to note. It's not a bad thing. It's just something to note if you don't want that feeling in the piece. Back there. Sketchbook. This is just a sketchbook. I don't have to be exact. And then, oh, that's a good idea. I want to get in here. Get a minute here.
How's that?
Oh, I kind of dig it. You guys dig it? One more. Shadow up there, but maybe some actual like foliage shapes here and there. Doesn't have to look like anything in particular, just lines and angles like that, just for a bit of visual interest. I dig it. Because there's a lot going on with this tree and its configuration. So we can just kind of scribble around a little bit and, you know, make it our own. Make it your own, man. And then it has these weird pops of like fruit type colors that maybe come in. Get some some green going on here and there. Transition color. Good. Weird transition color here and there to that gold, purple to green to gold. Why not? Definitely going to give it an interesting look, right? So far down on this pencil too that I'm getting lines on the page. That's alright. Maybe some green, like, edging, peeking, green light poking, peeking here and there. Good. And then orange, like, flower things or fruit or whatever they are, kind of all over the place. Haphazard, sporadic, different sizes, kind of like that. Yeah, that has actually the feel that I want. Run on instinct, y'all. Run on instinct. And our half an hour is, or our hour actually, is almost up. We only have a few more minutes. So we'll finish up this tree. And then, yeah, I'll see you YouTube people. I will see next Sunday for sketching. Actually, I'll see you Monday for Mixed Media Monday video, but our next sketch session will be Sunday. And yeah, super looking forward to it. If you want more sketch session stuff, my Patreon, the $5 tier, you get all of the sketch session videos that I'm doing every day. For roughly an hour a day. Sometimes they're 40 minutes. Depends if I, you know, don't have quite enough time to do a whole hour. But usually they're about an hour. 55, 58, 54, you know, that kind of thing. So yeah. And then there's the monthly tutorial, vlogs, posts, a few posts a month about what's going on. Few mini blogs a month about what's going on, you know, with the business and how things are running and whatnot. I want to go in a little bit darker on that trunk. Chrome green from the metallics section. Is that still too bright? That might still be too bright. Nope, it's good. It's good. Just get in here and give the trunk some weight, some visual weight, is my thought pattern here. Yeah, dig it. And it kind of digs into the existing colors, and I'm kind of winging it here for aesthetics, for what it looks like. That. And down like that. Like that. Yeah. Gives us our visual weight that we need. Just skim it over the surface of the color that's already there. Like that. Drop this branch in. Branch. Base of this branch kind of just appears up there. Let's see, this is back behind there. But there. Get fully carried away at this point. come in down here, put in. Some sort of ground cover. Like that. Maybe some of our flowers fell off here and there. Oh, that's kind of cool. I dig it. Tree practice. And at a later date, I'll go through and fill in the rest of the page with other trees. Do little trees in the little spaces and a bigger tree over here. And yeah, it'll be super cool. And when I do at the end of the month, every month on Patreon, I do a sketchbook page flip. All the pages that we've done, that I've done in the sketchbook, because I do a lot of work outside of the videoing. It's personal work in the sketchbooks throughout the month that I do. So you guys get to see all the different personal work that I did for the month. Both the videoed and unvideoed elements. At the end of the month, every month on Patreon. These are the pastel ones that are here. And there we go. That is our sketchbook session for Sunday. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Let me know what you think in the comments below. I'd love to see you over on Patreon if you want to come over and join my very teensy community right now, but hopefully growing quickly or not quickly. Either way works for me. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!